While the COVID-19 pandemic has kept people around the world confined to their homes, the impact on lives and economies is enormous. Earth observation data provided by the European Union's Copernicus programme, as well as from the European Space Agency, ESA, can even see some of the effects from space. As many European countries have closed off their borders, satellite data is showing how economic sectors such as agriculture and transport have been affected by the various lockdowns, with great impact on our food supply chains and transportation within Europe.
We have recently provided some information of traffic congestions along borders of European Union countries, within Europe, not outside, but within Europe, for example, between Germany and Poland, between Austria and Italy, between the Czech Republic and Germany. And we have monitored these traffic jams or these queues along these borders as an indication or an information on what happens in different places in Europe. Quite interesting information. In fact, we forwarded this information to the European Commission, and it was picked up by European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen, who was actually in a tweet referring to this data of Copernicus, which we have produced by ESA, the European Space Agency, as one good example of how space can address the crisis in which we are right now.
In response to these traffic jams, the European Commission installed so-called green lane border crossings to enable swift transport within Europe. However, other food supply problems arise, mostly within the agricultural industry. The agricultural industry in Europe is heavily reliant upon migrant labour. These migrants are brought in temporarily to help with the harvest. But with countries having closed off their borders, these much-needed workers can't be used. This means that farmers have no choice but to not replant or even let crops go unharvested. Once again, the effects are even visible from orbit. And by comparing with satellite data from other years, the impact can be estimated.
In several countries, you are at the moment harvesting asparagus. And asparagus harvest needs a lot of workforce, typically from Eastern European countries, Romania, Bulgaria. But because the borders are closed, they cannot travel, or there's restrictions on travel. And therefore, some farmers have a problem in harvesting their asparagus. It may sound a bit trivial, but this is a real problem for the farming community. And what we can see from space is whether the fields are being harvested or not, and what the state of harvest is, whether it's later or the same time as usual, and whether some farmers have decided simply not to plant because of the current situation in which we are. So there are many of these parameters where we can use satellites to really see what is going on and how this COVID crisis can affect daily life of people, but also of the economy.
While these events could create a shortage of fresh produce or even scarcity driving up prices for consumers, the impact on agriculture and on farmers is devastating. As satellite imagery shows, in recent years the industry has already been ravaged by droughts, and now once more the harvest and planting of produce is compromised. As we prepare for the world of tomorrow, we need to look at our planet and see how we can sustain and diversify the food supply for all people on Earth. Here, ESA and the Earth observation programs could once more play a pivotal role, taking the pulse of our planet.